you need to pay attention to is it shows scale and context. So you're gonna do a final rendering of your final design. The design may have evolved a little bit as you went through the process of orthographic views and your exponent views and your planetary views. And by now you know the final way it's gonna look. And you wanna do what we call a glamour shot, which would be the final image that a client would see. So it'd be something you would show to the CEO of a company, like this is what you've invested your money into up until this point, this is what it's gonna look like. Are you ready to write the check to get this product built? So this so-called glamour shot also sells the design to top management. And what I mean by showing scale and context is there's something in the drawing that shows how big the product is. So for your drills, you might want to show a little container full of drill bits, or you want to show a tape measure, or a coffee mug, or screwdriver, or something that would normally be around the drill, next to the drill.
Hand doesn't count. It's like putting your
hand is fine.
Okay.
As long as it's not doing something weird. And then you want to show context. So context means what does the product do and how does it do it? So maybe you want to show a hand on the drill and the drill is actually drilling a hole or putting a screw in something, or it's got a screwdriver bit in it and there's some screws laying on the table next to it, so you can see, oh, he's about to put screws into something with this drill. So that's what this is. It's showing scale and context. There's a person on it, so you get a sense of how big it is, and it's mowing long, so you know what it's doing. And I've got some other sketches here, but none of them are drills. Let's see what else we have here. By X out of this is going to go away. How about a toilet brush? Maybe you'd like to see a toilet brush. Okay, so this isn't exactly your assignment, because this person obviously used Photoshop. If you want to go ahead and use Photoshop to put in context, that's what this is. But in this case, the scale is shown with the hand, and the context is shown with the other bathroom fixtures across the top. So that's another way you can show context. Oh, there's also a little explanatory in here, but you got the other explanatory view. That thing's too bright. It's showing up a lot better on my computer screen. So this final rendering is pretty tight. It should be a little bit tighter than your final three. Anyway, this is one of my old renderings. It's showing scale and context. So that's what you need to do for your final rendering. So that's about all I'm going to give you. You could work in class today on your homework that you didn't do because you're too busy on your wood chair project. And if you're done with that, you can start on this final rendering with scale and context. And then we're going to, that's the last piece of drawing for this project. And then you're going to put everything together in a presentation, the whole project, all those drawings that you did. Okay? So this person's actually got two renderings. There's one right here, which is showing, this is the one that's showing scale and context, which is the assignment I just gave you. got the hand, and it's got the piece of fruit there that's being peeled, so that's the scale and context. They've also added another final rendering here, which I'm not asking you to do, of just the product by itself. So your final rendering is going to include scale and context. And you need to put everything together in a presentation like this, so be thinking about this when you do your final rendering, because if this was in a big background, you might have a little hard time fitting that into a graphic, the overall presentation. So there's concept sketches across the top. There should be a final three, which I think is those right there. There's exploded view, the colored orthographic, the component layout, explanatory over here, which you can't see very well, also explanatory here, and the final rendering scale and context, and this is extra. So keep that in mind that this is what you're going to be doing next week when you're doing your rendering this due Thursday after tomorrow. Okay?
What is that one on the top?
Those are concept sketches across the top.
Okay, and the top right or left is the
final three. So you're going to need, next week, you're going to need the ability to scan, and you're going to need to know enough about Photoshop, Illustrator, that you can change the size of these and move them around. And you're also going to need to make some kind of a graphic background that kind of organizes the things on the page or leads your eyes through the whole project from beginning to end. So, I guess tomorrow I'll start demonstrating Photoshop on how to do that.
Tomorrow?
Thursday.
Is that, I guess, like the start of our homework for this coming weekend?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Thursday, I will give you the homework assignment to lay all this out like this. Okay? Anybody scared?
Just a little bit.
Okay, I'm going to turn the lights back on everywhere, but I recommend still using fixed-in lines, and no more detail than that.
So no hair?
No hair, yeah. No tattoos.
No tattoos.
You can see tattoos and stuff like that.
Okay, so here's an example of a concept. Is just an outline, and this is a constant. Wait, I didn't do this one, and his friend did this one. But you see how little detail there is? So let me see if I find some more here. And hands are very difficult to draw correctly. There's Spider-Man hand. I think it's somewhere here. Remember what I told you? Take a picture of your own hand holding something about the size of your drill, and then use it as an underlay. Get the size where you want it. Yeah, these are just some reference hands that I put on D2L for you. Somebody else did these. But maybe you can learn something from them. Can't get that one to go away. I keep clicking that red X and it won't go away. Come on, Nicole. I can't get into work now. I think I lost Nicole. Okay, Viz, turn it off.